Hey guys, I'm 3 minutes late. I said 7:30 at 7:33, but it's okay because no one's here. Yeah, okay. Just gonna put on some music for now. This song has a chokehold on me right now. Pensándote, Raúl Alejandro. Okay. Hey boo. Thanks for coming to my live. I started a little late. Okay, we'll pull up some questions now. Hey everyone. I'm in a like big dancing mood right now, so I'm gonna be dancing. Y'all can dance with me. Get a drink. Hi, Jenny. Thank you for being here, love. I'm gonna need a skincare routine, girl. Girl, let me tell you about that. I stay getting asked to make that video, and I fully intend on making it. However, I'm planning on making it a giveaway. So, like, everything that I'm using on my skin, I want to get all those products, gather them, and then be able to do a giveaway with those same products. So that's what I'm waiting on. I got to gather all of that. And also, like, my skin's actually kind of struggling right now. I know because I know where, like, how it looks when it's prime. So I'm trying to get it back to there before I do the skincare routine bit, okay? But I got you. All right, guys. I have quite a bit of questions. So I'm just gonna get started right away because there's a lot, and there's so many questions. Like, honestly, if I don't get into all of them, I'm so sorry. It's just that I know there's a lot of questions, and I love talking a lot. So, and there's questions where, like, there's a lot to say about them. You get me? Hold on, let me put some more lighting towards me, because this lighting is like, let's see, I guess a little bit better, but sorry for this blank space. Eventually, I'll fill this up so it doesn't look so boring. So, first question. Let's go in. What do you do for a living? So, right now, I currently work for a salon that has 4 locations here in Phoenix, Arizona. And I do their social media management, but also, like, management, like, all the management role or management tasks as well. So right now I'm working on becoming the manager there, but it's not my position yet. So that's what I do mainly. I do like videography, photography, social media. That's always been, I have a degree in creative media and film from NAU. So that's where I'm kind of trying to progress. I love the beauty industry. It's fun to work in it, but I'm just focused on the media side of things, and, like, being creative. Is the music too loud, by the way? Like, let me know if anything gets too loud, guys, and I'll turn it down. But yeah, that's what I do for a living right now. The place is called Raw Beauty Lounge here in Phoenix, and it's nice. I like the job a lot, and I like my boss. So that's what I'm doing for a living at the moment. Social media management, which is kind of funny because I don't even really, like, focus too much on my own Instagram, but, like, I dedicate myself to building socials. All right. What do you see yourself doing by the age of 30? The age of 30. That's 5 years away now. Which is actually, like, what the older you get, the faster time passes by, right? So 5 years is not that far away to me. Thank you, prima donna. We'll keep it at this level. So, wait, what was it? By 30. What do I see myself doing by 30? That's hard because, honestly, I'm going to keep it so real. Like, I feel like, how much is rent in Arizona? I'll get into that question right after this so I don't lose my train of thought. So I feel like with myself, I feel like I kind of pursue things for, like, sporadically. Like, I'll be like, I want this, I want to do this, and I want, well, no, I know what I want by 30, okay? By 30, I hope that I hope to be financially stable, financially independent. Like, I don't want to have to work anymore by 30. I wouldn't mind if, I'm not going to like rush myself to get to that point. If it happens at 35, that's fine. But I hope that by 30, you know, like I'm starting to see like significant growth in being financially independent. And I feel like I'm working towards that at the moment is, hi Laura, is becoming financially independent. So by 30, I hope I own some properties, you know, or have investments in some properties. That way I can get return and I passive income coming in. And just traveling, honestly, like traveling. And I would honestly really love dedicating myself to YouTube and creating videos, like actual like mini videos, like mini films, you know? Because like I said, I have a degree in film from NAU and I genuinely did enjoy film. Like I really do enjoy being creative and creating storylines and creating shots and just like, and photography and videography. I really enjoy all of that. But I feel like I took a step back from it. And now, like, a lot of ideas are pouring back in, and I feel like I want to get back into that. So maybe sometimes in my YouTube, you'll see, like, some of my films come through, okay? It's not just going to be about me. We'll see. But, yeah. Definitely that. I would just say by 30, I hope that I'm financially independent. Like, I don't have to work or anything or make income from anyone, and creating my films or mini films and my vlogs, you know, like just being free. Am I currently financially stable? I mean, do I pay all my bills? Yes. But am I still able to afford everything that I want yet and pay all those bills? I don't think I'm completely there yet. So that's what I'm working on. So I wouldn't say I'm financially stable yet, because sometimes I'm like, you know, I try to budget, but sometimes stuff still comes up. So, but I'm getting there. I'm close to it. Films, looking forward to your work. Yes. Like films, like story with storylines and whatnot. I created a few when I was at NAU because I was like, I had to do student work. But I was always so, so insecure about myself and like my work and like actually putting work out there and being creative, you know. I was so insecure about it because I was so hard on myself. So that's why you guys haven't seen anything like of that sort. But it would be nice to start off like start from scratch, you know, and start making new films and collaborate with people. So, yeah, I think you can look forward to that in the future. Okay, next question. Hi, everyone. Thanks for being here. Do I watch any YouTubers? I definitely do watch YouTube. Like, there's a reason why I wanted to become a YouTuber, because I definitely do watch YouTubers. And some, like, even I made a video of my morning routine that I have not posted yet, but you'll see me mention, a lot of YouTubers that I watch in that video. I watch, like, some tarot YouTubers. Like, I love tarot readings. For like my zodiac sign. I love what's the other one I mentioned like a workout routine that I follow that's on YouTube as well. And what's the other one I mentioned? Oh, like a playlist. Like he's a DJ, I think, and he does like mixes. So I love that too. So yeah, I watch a whole bunch of YouTubers. Like I cannot name them off the top of my head, to be honest, but just know like there's a lot of them. Yeah, definitely watch YouTube a lot. The glasses from Target. I literally just got it today. I was like, and I just left it on my table and I was like, let me just use this right now because it's cute as hell. Like, yeah, it's from Target. Thank you. Ralph Smart. Brandy, what were you trying to say there? Laura, how I became spiritual. Oh, I'm about to get into it. Like, this is a story, guys. I mean, I'll keep it short and sweet, but I've come a very, very long way to like where I am now, like my spirituality now. I used to be like, especially in college, like I was reckless. Like, let me just start with that story there. Like, when I was in university and I lived away from home, I was super reckless. I mean, reckless with like my emotions, my heart, my mind, like my emotional health, everything, right? Like I was just so reckless with all of it because I didn't believe in that stuff. Like I legit used to make fun of, like, the spiritual girls. Like, I clearly remember that, like, making fun of with my best friend, like, making fun of those girls who believe in this stuff. And, like, I was so genuinely, I was so bitter. Like, I was so freaking dead inside, you know? Oh, I see, Brandy. Okay, I'm gonna look into that. Thank you. So yeah, I was so dead inside. Like, I'll be the first to admit that. Like, even my best friend, who's a lot more cynical than I am, was even like, okay, like, you're kind of like going too far. I used to even say to her, like, love doesn't exist. Like, that's bullshit. Like, what is that? Like, how sad is that? Like, I legit used to think like that. And that was due to, like, past traumas and whatnot, right? Like, both in romantic... Oh, wait, the same song's replaying over and over again. Hold on. But past traumas, like, both in romantic relationships and in what I've seen with my parents, right? Like, that, it started there. It stemmed from there, like, not believing just not believing in love, not believing in spirituality, not believing in anything, and not having faith in anything. Like, that's how I used to be. And I was struggling. Like, I was super, super duper stressed out. Like, even, like, I remember, it's funny because it even showed in my body. Like, I was so, like, my face was full of acne. Like, it was just horrible. I would eat, like, shit, like, McDonald's every day, like, Maruchans and ramen, like, all that stuff every day. Like, that's how I carried myself. And it got to the point where, like, that shitty behavior and, like, also, like, casual hookups that were, like, so pointless and just left me feeling empty inside. So all that shitty-ass behavior eventually obviously led me to, like, go downhill, right? Like, of course, eventually that's all that stuff catches up with you. All your bad habits come get back to you. So I went really low. Like, I got to my lowest point. Like, genuinely, I thought I was not gonna come out of this. Like, it was so miserable. Like, I really went into a deep, deep depression. Like, that's where that took me, you know? To the point where, like, I didn't see a point in life. Now, I wasn't ever suicidal, to be honest. Like, I'm not saying that. But even then, I still was like, what is the point to this, you know? So I definitely went super... And then what was it? What was it really that made me think, like, I cannot tell you specifically what it was that made me, like, light bulb, like, this is, of course spirituality is real, of course love is real, all this. Like, honestly, I wish I could remember. I'm sure that I journaled a lot, so I'm sure that if I look back, I'll have it, like, written down. But I had to go to the deepest pits, like, of my life to then realize, like, hold on, like, I think it was a lot of, like, doing my own research and obviously spending time alone, like, 100%. I had to do a lot of my own research, look into my own, like, reflect and think about, like, what are my own beliefs? What are my own values? What do I support? There was a lot of that, like, reflecting on, like, what I really believe and what I think about myself, right? So then, like, watching so many videos and reading so many books and then, like, being with myself, somehow I got to the point where I'm like, I really do feel my spirit with me, like, genuinely. And actually another huge thing that helped me, like, I'm not gonna lie, like, and this is actually leading into another question that I had. I would microdose on shrooms by myself. Like, I would take, like, a little capsule filled of, like, filled with, like, little, like, powdered shrooms, right? And I would microdose those, and then I had, like, an epiphany. I had a life-changing experience. It was really, like, it was crazy to me because I feel like I hadn't experienced anything like that before, but I felt like my spirit was there with me while I had that little, like, microdose trip, you know, like it was a small trip, but I meditated while I was on that little trip, and that's when it came to me, and I was like, what the hell, like my spirit is so real, and my spirit has been there by my side my whole life, and I just wasn't paying attention to it. And ever since then, I'm like, why am I treating myself like this? Like, this body that I have is the vessel that is carrying my spirit that loves me so much. So why am I treating the vessel that my spirit is in so badly? Like, I want to take care of it, and I want to love it and cherish it. And ever since then, literally ever since then, I chose to never talk shit, like never say anything negative about myself in my head ever again. Like, obviously, like, those things do come up, but like, I'm conscious of like, this is not how I want to be treating myself. Like, I love myself too much, you know, like, yeah, Jenny, you get it? Like, for real, I'm glad the old me's in the past too, because she was something else. But don't get me wrong, even that old Cynthia, you got to be grateful. Like, I got to be grateful for her, because she was who I needed to be at the moment, as shitty as it was. But if I wasn't her, I would have never become the Cynthia I am now. So, yeah, ever since then, ever since that little microdose trip I had, like, 100%, I feel like I had an experience that I could never come back from afterwards. Like, nah, like, that's it. Like, my spirit is here with me. This is the body that my spirit is being held in, and I'm going to cherish it. I'm going to show spirit, like, hey, like, I love you, and thank you for loving me back. So I would say that's what really jump-started, like, my spirituality and, like, my spiritual journey, you know? Let me put on the playlist. But why did you name your dog Saint? Okay, I'm gonna keep it 100. Do you wanna know why I named my dog Saint? Ever since Kim named her son Saint, I was like, that's a dope ass name. And then Saint came to my life, and he's all white. He looks like a little angel. I was like, your name's Saint. But he's not a saint. Like, literally, it's I could not have called him any, I could not have named him anything more ironic, because he is the furthest thing from being a saint. I still love him though. What should I put on? I don't even know what I want to listen to. Thank you guys for being here and for all the questions. How old am I? I'm 25. Why did I break up with my ex? Broke up with my ex. Oh, and also, like, we addressed this. My ex and I made a video of us. He's actually in the chat right now. He's the one commented, why did you name your dog Saint? That's my ex. But we broke up because, and we made this video, right, that I said we were going to do a Q&A. Like, I was going to do a Q&A with my ex. We literally made the video, recorded it and everything. I edited it, and, like, I was ready to post. And then it just would not post for the life of me. I tried so many times. It just did not want to upload. And I'm like, all right, you know what? I'm going to take this as a sign. Like, I do, like, the universe does not want me to post this video with my ex. So I left it at that. I was like, I'm not trying again. But we broke up because, and I'm not going to go into detail about it, but there was an issue that we could not resolve. It was there from the beginning of our relationship, like when it started, and every time it would pop up again, we would just sweep it under the rug type of deal, you know, like, oh, we'll work on it, and just sweep it under the rug, right? And over time, it's just like, okay, like, we can't just keep ignoring this, like, we can't just keep sweeping it under the rug. And then the last time that it came up was the point where we were like, okay, like, it's time to, like, go our separate ways, you know? But the good thing is that it was super mutual, and we still have immense respect for each other. We're still such good friends, because at the end of the day, yeah, he was my boyfriend, but he was my best friend before my boyfriend. Like, he was my best friend. Like, literally, like, that's exactly how we treated each other, like, best friends. So when we broke up, like, we agreed we'd still be friends, and like we still talk, you know, like it's not like that, it's not even like romantically or anything, but we'll catch up, like, oh, what are you doing, like, what's up. He's in Vietnam right now, so I'm like, you know, like catching up with him about that, just stuff like that, like how best friends do you get me? So exactly, Miriam. And that's why I feel really lucky, you know, that I'm not like, it wasn't like a shitty breakup or anything. All right, next question. Yeah, that spiritual one like threw me for a loop. I told y'all I was gonna talk a lot about each question. I'm gonna try to keep them short, don't worry. I say that, but in reality, I'm gonna just speak my piece. Okay, I answered all the questions in the chat for now. Okay. Oh, wait. Do you think everyone should experience shrooms at least once in their lifetime? Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Like, I cannot emphasize how, like, I'm such an advocate for that. I don't do them anymore, which honestly, I would not be opposed to doing a microdose again. A full trip, I'm good, but a microdose, I'd probably try it again. But I think everyone should try it at least once, like 100%, 110%. I've even literally like told my family about this, because why? Because even they notice, like, oh, like she's actually really positive and she's making strides in her life and she's really motivated, right? So they noticed that difference in me after the microdosing. And I talked to them about it, and like I'm just so passionate about what shrooms does to our system. And this is why I advocate for shrooms so deeply, because I've only ever smoked weed and done shrooms, right? So both those things come from the earth. They're natural. They're not man-made. They don't have any chemicals in them, right? Like, I haven't done acid, nor do I care to. I just don't really care. Like, I don't care. Like, I don't really feel an interest, an incline towards it. I did shrooms because it's from the earth too, and weed because it's from the earth, right? So both of those things I'll advocate for. Shrooms, I almost feel like, I remember when I was doing the microdosing, I feel like shrooms, they come from the earth, right? They're created by earth, and I feel like the earth is trying to say, like, here, take this, like, this was made for you, almost, like, even though it's not the case. Obviously humans don't, like, nature is nature, humans aren't, like, nature is not just meant for humans, but I do genuinely feel like shrooms were almost made to be, like the universe saying, like, look, what I make for you is your nourishment, right? So I take these shrooms, and I'm, like, I really feel like the earth and the universe is speaking to me. Like, when I do shrooms, I feel so grounded. Like, I feel so connected to the earth and, like, the universe and, like, where I come from, right? And it's funny because shrooms come from the earth, and they remind me of where I come from and the soil I come from. So, no, I have not done any other drugs, because, like I said, I feel like I'm good off of just, like, what's made, like, from the earth. So shrooms, like I said, changed my life. They took me out of that pit that I was in. And honestly, I know it sounds like really exaggerated, but I feel like I can really say this, because I feel like I can credit all of my self-love and confidence to shrooms. Like, I'm gonna keep it so real. Like, the reason why I love myself so much and have this confidence is because that one shroom trip that I mentioned earlier, like, it really did change my life. And it made me realize, like, I will never not love myself ever again. And it's stuck with me since. So, like, yes, I highly recommend doing shrooms. And, like, I'm not the only one who will say this. Like, oh, my bad. I'm not the only one who will say this, you know? Like, I feel like when I talk to people about the shrooms and, like, their shroom trip, they say kind of a similar experience. So that tells me something, too. Like, we should all try this, you know? And they all tell me the similar experience is this. They get an overwhelming sense of joy and self-love. to the point of like literally me, like when I did that, like when I had that shroom trip, I cried. Like I cried from like the realization I had, like, damn, like how come I wasn't loving myself? You know, it was so intense. The self-love that I felt for myself on that little trip was so intense that I just started crying, literally. And then another friend who tried it too said the same exact experience. Like exactly what I went through is what they went through. So I'm like, yeah, like this is amazing. Like I feel like this should definitely be like more researched and looked into, you know, especially for people with anxiety and depression. So exactly, Heidi, exactly. That's exactly what it did for me, I feel like. Like literally lifted a veil or like a screen that I was looking through and was so cynical and negative, you know, and it lifted it from me. So let me go back to the, and someone asked if I'm a daily smoker. Honestly guys, I don't smoke unless like someone offers me, just like, hey, you want to hit this? That's when I was like, when I was smoking. But honestly, like I'm at a point right now where I don't even want to smoke or drink. I don't know, right? I could say like, oh, I'm never gonna drink or smoke again, but like who knows really. But in my head, I kind of feel like I'm over it. Like I don't really want to drink or smoke anymore. Like I kind of like, I enjoy being sober. I enjoy my sober version more than I do my drunk or drinking version. You know, like I love sober me. So I don't know. We'll see. I'm saying right now I don't want to drink and smoke anymore. If it happens, it happens. But okay. Are you going on dates or am I using dating apps? Okay, I downloaded Bumble, okay? And I saw one guy and I was like, this guy looks nothing like he does in his pictures. So after that, I was like very like, I'm over it. So yeah, I did download Bumble just because I was like, it was weird to like jump from being in a long-term relationship to them being single out of nowhere. So I did try it out, you know, even though I didn't want anything serious, but really, I was just looking for a distraction. Like, I'm just being so honest right now. But I regret it. I'm like, I just deleted it. It's like, no. So, no, I'm not on dating apps right now, but I did get on one. And if I am going on dates, not at the moment. I'm just really focused on myself right now. Like, I just don't really care about being interested in a guy right now, to be honest. Let's see. What's your fave sign for a friend and lover? Jeez, I'm rushing up. For a friend, that's hard because, I mean, even for a lover, it's hard because I'm a Libra, right? So I feel like, and this is not on no cocky shit, I mean it. I get along with most people and most signs. I would say maybe Cancer and Scorpio are the ones that sometimes I have a harder time with, you know? But I guess, no, actually that's, I know who, for friends, Virgos and Capricorns have always been my best friends. Like, I don't know why. Oh, my moon sign is my moon is in Virgo, right? So one of my best friends is Capricorn and the other one's a Virgo. Let me tell you something wild real quick. Like, so I'm a Libra sun, Virgo moon, and the Libra rising, right? And then my Virgo best friend, I'm like, let's look into your chart. And then turns out she's a Virgo sun, a Libra moon, and a Libra rising. I was like so dumbfounded by that. I was like, no wonder we just literally have like flipped sun and moon. So that's why we get each other so good, you know? What about your hoeing? How do you find your clients? Oh, it's kind of funny, but you know, I was intent kind of in the, wait, let me not change, hold on, I was on one question, hold on, y'all coming at me too quickly. So friends, I would say Capricorn and Virgo, and Capricorns I always get along with, like immediately, like we're like this. So I love a Capricorn. A Capricorn woman, like, we're going to be like this. Lover. I would also say probably Capricorn and Virgo. Okay, maybe I have favorites. Because Capricorn and Virgo, guys, like, we always end up having the thing. Even though it doesn't work out, because Capricorn and Libra, and then Capricorn, or Virgo and Libra, they're just not compatible ever. But we always end up having a thing for each other, so. I guess it's that, Capricorn and Virgo. Jenny, I totally understand that. And Laura, too. I totally understand that 100% because I'd be like that, too. Sometimes, even before I would do the microdose, I felt like that. Oh, let me tell you what helped me, though. And this would probably help you guys. Before I did the little microdose, I would set an intention. So, like, okay, I'm going to do this little microdose with the intention of this. And I kid you not, I would do the shroom trip, and that's exactly what would happen. Exactly. Like, I would be like, I think one time I was like, I'm gonna do this little microdose to look into, like, or heal a bit what me and my brother have been through, you know, and, like, our past and all that. Literally, I kid you not, came out of that feeling amazing afterwards. Even, I'm not gonna kid you, like, that shit hurt. Like, it hurt, but I, like, journaled a lot. I cried a lot during it. But all of that felt so relieving. It felt like, it felt like so, like, I don't know, just freeing, you know? So I think if you set an intention, that's exactly what you're gonna get out of the shrimp trip, you know? So just do that. And then that way, when you're like, during the trip, you're not gonna feel as scared because you know why you did it. And you can keep reminding yourself of that, you know? So, do I like Sagittarius? Yeah, I love a Sagittarius, honestly. Like, they're so fun-loving and, like, outgoing and positive. So, definitely love Sagittariuses. You like to read books? Yes. I have, like, stacks and stacks of books over here that I'm not going to show y'all because they're a mess over there. But I love reading books. I love, I love gaining more knowledge, period. Like, constantly. So, what about your hoeing? How do you find clients? Okay, Frenchie, that one, I'm not even really hoeing right now. Like, I'm keeping it so real. Like, I just don't, like I said earlier, like, I just don't really care. Like, I'm just not interested in it right now. So I think I'm just doing me and, like, focusing on what I want to build. Like I mentioned earlier, like, my financial independence, how I'm going to get there, my own business, you know, like, that's what I'm kind of focusing on right now that I'm alone. But when I am building up a roster, I'll let you know. And then when I get more tattoos, lately, I've been telling myself, like, I don't want any more. I really don't. Like, I don't want to look tatted up, you know? Not that it looks bad. Whoever has it, that looks great. If you're happy with it, good. But lately, I just don't want any tattoos. Like, I don't want to look super tatted. So, probably not, honestly. But if I do, I don't know, I could say no, but I probably will eventually, you know? Okay, let me look into the next one. Yes, Brandy, that works out perfectly. It really does. Was it hard to get in front of a camera and express yourself? You're great at it. Oh, that's very sweet. But honestly, it was so hard. It was so hard. If you watched my first video, like, I don't know if any of y'all did watch my first video, but I was literally, like, stuttering and running out of breath, and I felt so embarrassed. I literally had, like, a mini breakdown during the filming. Like, it was hard. It was so hard. I'm not gonna lie, like, and I felt cringe too, and I felt cringe while I was recording, and I felt cringe while I was uploading, but I was like, I don't care, I literally don't care anymore, like, I just need to do it, and look at where it's gotten me, guys. Like, I'm so proud of myself now. Like, you just gotta do it, even when it's hard, you know? Like, the point is just doing it. Um, encouragement to start YouTube. Perfect lead-in. Honestly, the encouragement I would say is, like, I don't think it's ever gonna be like, you're never gonna be ready to do anything. You just have to do it. That's what I learned the day I posted that first video, is you just have to do it, because but yeah, I think the biggest encouragement that I could tell myself is, like, I don't care, because I don't care what people think anymore. Like, even if it is cringe, oh well, like, I'm at least I did it. What I cared about more than anything when I posted that first video is my opinion versus anyone else's. Like, I don't care what anyone thinks, I don't care what they're gonna see. All I care is that I did it and that I feel proud of myself. So that's what I would say. Like, encourage yourself, like, pep talk yourself. Don't care about anyone else's opinions, and do it even though it's gonna be hard. You know, just do that shit, girl. Okay, biggest turn on and turn off in a man. Biggest turn off is a guy who's judgmental. Biggest turn off, so I'm going in. Guy who's judgmental, a guy who doesn't pay during, like, the whole talking stage. Like, if we're, like, I get it, once we're boyfriend and girlfriend, like, I understand that we can, like, obviously we'll end up being a team, right? And I want to take you out and pay too sometimes. But, like, during the whole talking phase and all that, while you're trying to get me, I should not be paying a cent. And if I am, it's like, you're done. No. Like, it just shouldn't be that way, you know? Another turnoff is closed-mindedness, which goes with the judgmental, you know? If you're closed-minded, I just can't do it. Like, I don't know. Like, if you find things weird easily, or, like, or you judge things easily, it's just, like, I don't know. It annoys me. It's just, like, I just want you to be open-minded and, like, understand that other people are the way they are because that's who they are and because of their experiences, you know, and that's it. Like, so that's a huge turn off to me. So it goes into a turn on, like, a guy who's open-minded. I love that. And a guy who just goes for what he wants. Like, my biggest turn on is a guy who just goes for what he wants and doesn't even look back. Like, he's like, I want her and I'm gonna get it. And, like, he's adamant. Like, I'm gonna take you on a date. I'm gonna show you why you should be with me. Like, literally, one of my exes, not the recent one, but from way in the past, literally got me just by doing that. Which he was not even my type at all. Like, look wise, all of that. Like, he was just not my type, not at all whatsoever. But because he was so consistent with me, and because he was so confident in himself that he was gonna be with me, and, like, did everything in his power to, like, make that known, and pursue me like that, like, we ended up together. Did it last? Obviously not. But the point is, like, you can get any girl you want if you, well, not any girl, I don't know about you guys, but for me, it's, like, super important that a man is confident, you know? And then, of course, another turn on, humor. You have to be funny. You just gotta be. That's a non-negotiable. What is something about yourself that you're working on? Oh, the easier question would be, what am I not working on, honestly? Because I feel like I'm just, like I said, like, I'm in my own zone right now. Like, I'm just focused on myself. So I feel like I'm working on everything. Like, I'm just, like, going through it, girl. Oh, actually, and I'm gonna give a quick shout out to Emma. I don't know if she got to catch this live, but she sent me a message earlier. We were having a conversation and stuff. She said she tried to tune in. And I told her I'd give her a shout out. So, hey, Emma, if you're here, I'm answering your questions, girl. So, thank you for your support. So the question is, what's something that you, about yourself that you're working on? I would say the biggest thing right now is falling back into my solitude again, because I'm not gonna lie, like, in the past, and it's embarrassing for me to admit, I'm gonna be honest, like, it's almost like I'm being very vulnerable when I say this, because I have to literally pride myself in being a woman who's, like, it's so easy for me to be alone and, like, be in my solitude, and I, like, I used to literally tell women this, right? And for me to feel like not comfortable being alone now after this long-term relationship, like that hurts me. You know, I'm like, why is it so hard to be alone and in my solitude again, you know? So I would say right now the biggest thing I'm working on is coming back to myself, enjoying my solitude again, and being there for myself again. That's the biggest thing I'm working on, is like enjoying my solitude again and knowing that it's serving a purpose, which has been hard. I don't know why. Like, have you always been so confident and loving towards yourself? This is one of my favorite artists right here, Eliza. Okay. So, have you always been so confident and loving towards yourself? No, honey. I don't think anyone is always confident and like loving to themselves, you know? And like with everything that I just said about my past, of course I did not love myself and I did not find my like confidence in myself all the time, you know? I feel like even when I'm not confident and not loving towards myself, I still have to keep the demeanor that I'm still confident in myself and I still love myself. Like even when I'm not really like super in love with myself, I have to remind myself like, but I do love myself, even when it's hard, right? Even when those thoughts come back up again, I have to remind myself like, this is not how you treat yourself. You love yourself. So it's not like, it's not always positive, right? You're not always gonna be positive. It's the same thing with confidence. You're not always gonna be confident. You're not always gonna be super loving to yourself, but you gotta remind yourself that you do love yourself and remain persistent with that. This is Wasn't Looking by Eliza, one of my favorites. I really recommend her. There's a lot of questions I'm just skipping through right now because I don't want to make this like a 3-hour long live. Oh, this is a good one that I definitely wanted to answer. The world feels so crazy. How do you calm any fear or worry? So the world is definitely crazy, but here's the thing. The world has always been crazy. Like, there has never been a moment where people don't think. There has never been a moment where people don't think that the world's about to end, honestly. Like, every generation before us, the 90s, the 80s, 60s, down to 20s, you know, have always thought, like, oh, this is going to shit, you know? Like, this is the world's about to end again. And, you know, politicians were still doing things wrong. So I would say it's all about perspective, right? It's about what you choose to look at. Personally, for me, like, and you can even tell, like, if you go to my Instagram, right? Like, I only follow a few, like, a couple people. And, like, these are people that I either, like, know in person or I follow as artists or whatever. But, like, I am very selective with what I'm choosing to see or allow into my life, right? Because if you're just like looking at news and looking at just anything, like you're just gonna see a lot of headlines. And headlines are meant to be negative. They're meant to bring you in with their negativity, right? So I would really filter out what you're looking at, who you're following, what you're putting your attention towards, honestly. Because in the words of Bretman, let me play y'all a little quick snippet of something that stays with me. Bretman Rock, okay, said, I love this shit so much. He said,
I was gonna stand here and lie to you guys that I never saw myself on TV, but that would be a lie because my mom only really watched TFC growing up, so everything that I absorbed on TV was Filipino people, so I was always seeing myself in TV. Yeah, so that's why when people say, like, I never saw myself on TV, girl, change the channel.
Change the channel, okay? Like, if you keep seeing the negativity, if you're not seeing what you want to see, change the channel. I'm not saying, and this is not to say like be ignorant. I'm not saying that because there's always going to be things out there that, you know, let's be informed, of course, right? But if you're only choosing to see the negative in everything, that's its own delusion. Like, you have to bring it in with the good. And also, like, I'm the queen of duality, okay? I believe in duality more than anything. Like, I'm a strong advocate for duality. So if there's any bad or any good in the world, it has to be accompanied by its opposite, right? So if there's going to be good in the world, there's going to be bad. That's just the truth. So the world is always going to look crazy. It's always going to look like it's in a crazy place or it's shitty. It's always going to look like that. Why? Because there's good in the world. And if there's going to be good, there's got to be bad with it. So I would just say, what are you going to focus on, right? If you're going to focus on just bad, then the world's going to be crazy and it's going to be shitty and it's going to be negative all the time to you. So yeah, just change your perspective, or just not perspective, but like pay attention to what you're letting into your mind, you know, filter it out, be selective. I don't want to talk about that, honestly, Jenny. Like, I don't want to talk about any of that. It's over. Like, I don't care for it. If you guys have any questions about her, I don't want to talk about it. Like, it's been over and done for me, so, like, respect that, y'all. All right, next question. Are you religious in addition to being spiritual? So, thanks, Jenny. So, I would say, I just saw something too, like, recently. It's about, you know, like, you know how that new documentary came out on HBO about La Luz del Mundo, about that, like, kind of cult, you know? So this one woman who was in it, she said that, like, when she was going through a hard time, like, getting out of that cult, she saw something, right? And it literally said, like, I can't remember it word for word, but it also impacted me. It said, trust in Jesus, or have faith in Jesus, not in man, not in this earth, not on this earth. And that made sense, because personally, I understand how religion is the source of so much pride and joy to people. I understand that, and that's fine. I'm not coming for y'all. But to me, religion is a man-made thing. It has nothing to do with Jesus or God or our spirit. Religion is just for man. I don't think it has to, that this is my opinion, y'all. So that's the way I see it. I don't put my faith and my salvation towards man or just material things on earth, which is religion. Like, that falls, like, religion falls into that category. So to me, like, I have faith, and faith alone. I don't feel like I have to be a part of a religion to have my faith. So I feel like religion has just kind of, like, set people apart, you know, like, has pulled them apart, if anything, instead of put us all together, which is what religion, ultimately, every single religion kind of says the same thing. Like, we're all one. We all come from the same place, right? And then we created religions, and now we're all separate in our separate religions. And that's fine, you know, because we have different beliefs. We're people, right? We're humans. We're always going to have differing opinions. But to me, I just have faith in and trust in what I come from, like, or in my spirit, because I don't know where I come from. I don't. Like, who knows what our God really is, right? I just have faith that there is a higher power, and that I'm a part of that higher power, because I've seen proof of it. And that's basically the premise of every religion, right? But I just don't see myself as, like, being a part of a religion ever. But I do have faith, 100%. I'm super faith. Like, I have so much faith in me, and I pride myself in that too. But as for religious, no, not at all. I don't go to church, but I have gone. I was raised Catholic. So, you know, I went through that pipeline, you know, that Catholic to atheist pipeline. But I'm not an atheist. Obviously, I believe in something and I have faith now. But I don't believe in religion. I don't go to church. I feel like I have my own practices where I know how, where I know or decide how I can connect to my spirit, and that's what I believe in. And I practice those practices with myself, you know? People you look up to, or who are some people you look up to, and what was your childhood like? Two completely different questions in one. But people I look up to, that's kind of hard for me sometimes, because I've come to the belief of, like, I don't really put anyone above anyone else, you know? So I feel like even celebrities, right? Even with a celebrity, I'll probably be super starstruck, who knows, right? If I see them in person. But even with celebrities, I don't put them on a pedestal. Like, oh, this is like, they're so amazing. They're like not even human like me, you know? Like, no, I don't really like, so it's hard for me to look up to people. I feel like I draw inspiration from people, from other people and celebrities and artists, of course. Like, that's definitely, like, that happens easily. I draw inspiration from them. But as far as, like, look up to them and, like, that's who I want to be like, nah. Like, I just want to be like myself and then create what I want to create, or, like, do what I want to do with how they've inspired me. You know, I don't really want to put them above me, though. And then how was my childhood? I would say my childhood was very well balanced. Oh shit, turn this down. My childhood was very well balanced, which is so on brand for me being a Libra. It had a little bit of everything. Like, it had its joy and it had its you know, it's misery too. And it had its moments where I was spoiled and moments where I also did not was not able to have what we wanted as a family, right? I feel like I had a mother who was very like, be free and be who you want to be and just do whatever makes you happy. But then she was also very strict. So you see what I mean? It was very much like that. Like, it was very well balanced, but it was contradictory. But nonetheless, I look back on my childhood with joy, and I'm super grateful for it. So, I don't know if that question was looking for any specifics about my childhood. Like, you know, like, if you wanted to hear something specifically about my childhood. If y'all have any questions about my childhood, let me know. All right, y'all. I'm only going to answer a couple more because this is going into an hour. I'll cut it off at an hour now. Okay, let's see. Let's do some good ones. What's your ultimate, what is or are your ultimate dreams or dream? So I would say my ultimate dream goes back to what I said also about my financial independence, not having to work. Eventually, I would like to get to the point where I'm not working and I'm just creating. I'm being creative and I'm inspiring others to be creative, and also just inspiring them to be themselves. You know, ideally, I would like to get to a point where I'm just focused on helping others, you know, become the best version of themselves, or not even the best version, but just themselves, you know, and really embrace that. I think that that's one of my highest values, is like helping others be themselves. Like, that's my biggest priority, because if we can be ourselves, like, we're gonna see so much progress on this earth. Like, we're gonna each individually contribute our parts, knowing what our part is, you know. So to me, eventually, my ultimate dream is going to get to the point where I'm not working, but I still have income, and I'm traveling and exploring my life while I have it, and also encouraging others and teaching others how to get to that point too, if they want it, right? That's my ultimate dream, is to just like help others, like embrace being themselves, not having to work. Really. That's about it. But I know that that's what I want to get to eventually. Like, that's always been a goal of mine. And like through different mediums, right? Like right now, for example, I'll be talking through YouTube and like talking about this and that, giving advice about this and that. But eventually I would like to create films or like mini films where I'm also creating storylines that are like where it shows character development, right? Or sometimes maybe one day I'll be painting, maybe one day I'll be writing a book. Like that's my goal, to be able to help others embrace being themselves through all my creative forms, you know, if that makes sense. All right, let's do like one or two more. Do you believe in reincarnation? Do I believe in reincarnation? That's a hard one because I don't know. I don't know if I believe in reincarnation because it's hard. It's hard. It's hard to believe. Personally, for me, it's hard to believe in anything other than my spirit, right? Do I know what happens with my spirit after this? No, and I don't. I try not to think about it because I'm just not sure, and like I don't want to have a set belief, and like, you know, like none of us are ever gonna know. So, but reincarnation, I feel very 50-50. Like, yeah, it could happen, but also I don't know. I don't think it could not happen, right? So that's how I feel about anything that has to do with afterlife. Like, I don't know. All I know is that I feel my spirit in me. I've experienced my spirit, so that's what I believe in. I don't know about anything after life. Like, I don't know what happens to my spirit after this life. Do I like to cook? And what are my favorite foods? Top three. I do like to cook when I get a chance. Sometimes I get really lazy and I'm just not in the mood to, and I won't. But when I do cook like a good home, like a homemade meal, I feel really proud of myself, and I'm like, oh, like this is nice. And I try to eat healthy all the time, so when I cook, it's like definitely something healthy, and like I feel so proud of myself because I'm eating from something I made, and I know what's in this, and I'm eating good. And my top three favorite foods, it's hard. I'm a huge breakfast girl. Like, I love breakfast. I'm such a, like, when it comes to breakfast, I want all of it. Like, the eggs, the bacon, the waffles, the pancakes, like, all of it, the hash brown. Like, I could have breakfast for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, straight up. People always judge me for that, but I'm like, I don't know. Honestly, it might be because, like, I associated, like, really good memories to breakfast. You know, like, this is when, like, breakfast was one of the times where all my family would get together. And it would just always be a happy time, you know? So maybe ever since then, like, I just, like, associated this taste with, like, joy. And, like, I just love breakfast. Honestly, so, yeah, I would say my top three foods are, like, all breakfast foods. All right, y'all. I'm about to cut it off here. Honestly, time went so quickly. Like, how has it already been an hour? I literally feel like I've been talking for 15 minutes straight up. That's crazy. Time flew. Wow, to anyone who's still here, like, y'all are some troopers because I got y'all here for an hour. You have the heater on. It's cold as fuck. It's so cold today for no reason. I'm like, chill, even during the day. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna end it here. Unless you guys have any questions, I'll wait like 30 seconds for y'all if you have any. How's y'all's night going? What's today? Monday. Mm-hmm. Jenny, thank you for all the questions, girl. You were avid. You were engaging on here. This is what I love. Yes, I will. And I hope to see you in them more often. I mean, more often. Well, when I do them, I hope to see you in them. And thank you to everyone who asked questions, too. Like, I got a lot of questions, and I'm so sorry I didn't get through all of them. I literally tried. Like, I told myself, like, yeah, I'll be able to get through all of them. But then here I go, like, talking for an hour for each question. So, sorry, guys. But thank you so much for all the questions, guys. I appreciate you for being here. I look forward to doing these more often. And I love y'all. And thank you for the support. It means the most to me. Sending you love. Have a beautiful week. All right. Bye, guys.